West of the equatorial region of the Pacific, the Marshall, the Mariana, and the Caroline Islands are the nearest archipelagos to the Asian coast. Some of the islands are the peaks of a chain of underwater volcanoes running from Japan to Papua New Guinea. Others were created by coral, together with an infinite number of lagoons, channels and atolls, blue holes and underwater canyons. The Mariana Trench, 11,000 meters below sea level, is the deepest marine abyss of our planet. We're in the heart of the Palau Archipelago. In this corner of the Pacific, the islands are mostly small, hence their name, Micronesia. A very few have coral powder beaches or a scattering of palm trees. Underwater, many of these islands communicate with each other through a labyrinth of grottoes and underwater canals. These grottoes contain many memories of the sea and the animals that inhabit it. A school of fusiliers thread their way like a living wall along the coral shelf to reveal the entrance to a cavern. The water is so limpid that it diffuses the sky's reflection even at a depth of 30 meters. The inhabitants of the place are those species least dependent on sunlight. Squirrel fish and soldier fish, with their large eyes, can avail themselves of the tenuous twilight, but their ruby-colored scales are invisible in natural light. A slight current from the open sea guides us inside the cave, suggesting that there are other openings. We're in a sea lake, in a world where green replaces the blue of the ocean. This is the kingdom of millions of tiny living jewels. The barrier that closes the bay, covered with a thick tropical forest, ensures that within the lagoon, the sea is always calm. Glassfish, attracted by the calm waters and the absence of predators, hover like a swarm of bees around the coral reefs. We're going down toward the bottom again. The blue holes are well-like openings dug out by marine erosion along the base of the coral reef. This world of shadows hides many treasures. The roof of a cave is ornamented with huge stalactites. These calcareous deposits cannot form underwater. In this submerged cathedral, they are memories of a time long past, when the level of the sea was much lower. In the heart of the cave, a wonderful surprise awaits us. Out of the darkness, an extraordinary creature emerges, an inhabitant of the deepest ocean abyss, unchanged after millions of years. The Nautilus is a true living fossil. In many Pacific islands, believing the creatures had the power to ward off evil spirits, the natives would place nautilus shells on the roofs of their houses. The harmonies coaxed by the ocean winds inspired new legends. The sunset casts all the glamour of the southern seas and announces a great change under the sea. We're on the outer edge of the Palau Archipelago. Not far from us, the coral reef transforms into a wall, which descends to a depth of 1,000 meters. During the night, the Nautilus abandons the colder, deeper waters and rises towards the ocean surface. Once more, in the labyrinth of caves and underwater passages, we reach a depth of 40 meters. This time, we see a colony of Nautili. It's quite a remarkable encounter. In 1829, for the first time, a naturalist was able to observe a live Nautilus. A near relative of the octopus and cuttlefish, the Nautilus is the only cephalopod that possesses an outer shell, an object that has fascinated not only collectors. Its spiral form has been closely studied as a perfect example of natural symmetry. The Nautilus travels between different depths by controlling the balance of gas and liquids in the various chambers within its shell. It swims horizontally by expelling jets of water from its siphon, as does a squid or an octopus. Many meters up, another migration is underway, no less unusual. A large school of big-eye emperors has gathered not far from the ocean surface. At a mysterious signal, all the fish swim upward. The coral reef forms an enormous shield against the tides. Cool water, rich in